Hi friends, this is Dr. Abdek. I am Chimthanawala. Today I will like to share one of a good case of a recurrent respiratory tract infection. Now this patient came to me with symptoms of recurrent cough and cold, recurrent bronchitis, recurrent lung infections. Every month he had to take a course of antibiotic and he used to feel better after that. It was so recurrent that the patient was tired of taking medicines. He had taken a lot of other system of medicines also which had failed, so he was referred to me. Now his symptoms are very, very precise, whatever he told me. He said, sir, these complaints are for the past 1.5 to 2 years. I get recurrent cough and cold. Even though if I don't eat anything cold, I don't take cold drinks, I take steam inhalations, I take proper care, my ears are always close so that the air does not go in, I wear that muffler and all, still I get recurrent cough and cold. And the cough is very severe, the whole passage is dry, there is dryness of whole passage. So I said, describe your dryness. So he said, sir, that there is dryness of the air passage and there is dryness of the throat also, the whole throat. So I said, the whole throat is dry or a particular part of throat is dry? So immediately told, sir, no sir, sometimes the dryness is here, sometimes the dryness is here, sometimes the dryness is here, and sometimes the dryness is here. This was a specific symptom which the patient was telling me, that dryness was here, discrete, sporadic. And also he added that there was a dry feeling in the tongue also. At the root of the tongue there was dry feeling, so he has to continuously swallow the saliva to make the tongue wet. Now a very important symptom and a very rare symptom the patient was telling. Whenever if you get this type of case, try to see what the patient is telling and try to analyze the symptom and then put it in the rubric form so that you can get a precise simile. Because whenever there is a symptom called dryness of the passage and recurrent cough and cold, we jump to lot other remedies which we have studied day in and day out. Like you can say tuberculum, you can say drosera, you can say causticum, you can say spongia, you can say aralia, you can say grindelia. But if the patient is trying to tell you the exact symptom, is trying to define that disease in a very peculiar way, take note of that symptom and then go and see the rubrications. So he had that inflammation of the bronchial tubes. He had inflammation of the lungs because of recurrent cough and cold, and this has become chronic. So in fact the patient in few minutes have told us lot of symptoms if we understand what the patient is trying to tell us. If we give ourselves time, if we give the patient's time, he will definitely tell you symptoms. Now what are the symptoms that the patient has told us? First thing he told, sir, I have got this recurrent cough and cold since 1.5 to 2 years. That means we are looking at a case of inflammation of the bronchial tubes, inflammation of the lungs, which are chronic in nature now. So our remedy must have this symptom, inflammation of the lungs, inflammations of the bronchial tubes, chronic. First thing. The second thing the patient described classically was the dryness. He had dryness of the air passage. A very important symptom, dryness, because once the patient has told dryness, then all the drugs which have a lot of mucus secretions are ruled out. So before ruling out these drugs, make sure that the symptoms are confirmed by the patients in his own language. Third symptom the patient was telling, the dryness was sporadic, sometime dryness here, sometime here, sometime here. But if you see our Mater Medica, there are no rubrics as dryness sporadic, or in Mater Medica there are no symptom as sporadic dryness of the throat. But my friends, there is a rubric and there is a symptom which says dryness of the air passage from throat in spots. In spots, kabhi hai dryness, kabhi hai ya. It is in spots. So the patient was classically telling us dryness of the air passage, especially in spots. So go home and read Mater Medica again. And second, and the last symptom the patient told, there's dryness of the air passage at the root of the tongue. Now these are the symptoms which the patient has told us. If you repertize this in the repertory chart, a very, very important drug that will come after rapid transition. It's a very important drug. It's a very important drug used in these type of conditions. I have used lots in my practice. I would not say for me it is a very rarely used drug or infrequently used drug. I use this drug quite oftenly. So what are the symptoms of this remedy? First is inflammation of the bronchial tubes, inflammation of the lungs, chronic in nature, dryness of the air passage, dryness of the air passage from throat in spots, dryness of the air passage in spots on the root of the tongue. These are the symptoms. In fact, the patient told in few minutes. If you repertorize this, one drug that comes to the repertoire is Stannum Iode. Yes, Stannum Iode, a very, very important drug prescribed or used in these type of conditions when these symptoms corresponds. I gave this patient Stannum Iode 200, first dose on the first day. He came after a week. He told, sir, I am at least 30 to 35% better, but I am feeling relaxed now. The dryness have gone, so that I don't have to continually swallow the saliva in order to get rid of the dryness. I repeated the dose after 15 days. He came after a month and he was very happy. He said, sir, 60 to 70% I am better. But he again added, okay, sir, I am better whenever I take any medicine, but it keeps coming on continuously. So I followed the patient for about 7 to 8 months and he had no attack of cough, cold, inflammation of lungs, and he did not have to take any antibiotics, free from disease. That is the magic of homeopathy. That is the magic of selecting a simlimum, and that is the magic of Stannum Iode. I hope you have understood the drug Stannum Iode. If you like this video, please do share and subscribe. Thank you.